radio station, its staff, management, or other sponsors. It's time for the Edge Radio Broadcast with your host, Daniel Ott. You can join Daniel and his guest as we discover the truth together. Within the continental U.S., call toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Fast Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. That's toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Fast Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. You can find out more about our guests and topics by logging onto the Edge's website at theedgeam.com. That's theedgeam.com. And now, here's your host for the Edge Radio Broadcast. Here's Daniel Ott.
February 1971, as Apollo 14 astronaut Edgar Mitchell hurled earthward through space, he was engulfed by a profound sense of universal connectedness. His intuitively sensed that his presence and that of the planet in the window were all part of a deliberate universal process, and that the glittering cosmos itself was in some way conscious. The experience was so overwhelming, Mitchell knew his life would never be the same. For the next 35 years, he embarked on another journey, an inward exploration of the ineffable mystery of human consciousness and being. Mitchell left NASA to form the Institute of Noetic Sciences. There he initiated research and studies of previously neglected by mainstream science, where he constructed a theory that could not only explain the mysteries of consciousness, but the psychic event, what the spiritualists call a miracle, and scientists dismiss altogether. Mitchell also created a new dyadic model of reality, revealing a self-aware universe not predetermined by the laws of physics, nor preordained by deities, nor infinitely malleable. While human actions are generally subject to the laws of physics, these laws are also influenced by the mind. His book, The Way of the Explorer, traces two remarkable journeys, one through space and one through the mind. Together, they fundamentally alter the way we understand the miracle and the mystery of being, and ultimately reveal humankind's role in its own destiny. That is the intro to the book, The Way of the Explorer, by Dr. Edgar Mitchell with Dwight Williams. Now let's go to our newsmaker line and see if we have Dr. Edgar Mitchell with us. Doctor, are you there?
Yes, I am. Thank you.
All right. Well, welcome to the Edge Radio Broadcast, Dr. Edgar Mitchell, and it's a pleasure to have you on tonight. And we're going to be talking, among other things, about your new book, The Way of the Explorer. And I just basically read the intro, which is a pretty astounding, because it looks like you went in the writing of this book, you went pretty much against the normal sort of scientific view of the Earth and reality and the miracles altogether. I mean, did you take a left turn off the beaten path? What happened to you?
Well, that's just what you call getting a bigger picture, I believe, mm-hmm. and then looking at some of the details of science that had been somewhat ignored before.
All right. And so, was this the writing of this book, and it looks like it's as you say, it's a journey through the material and the mystical worlds. Is it safe to say that you didn't start out believing in the mystical world, or were you always sort of a mystical, spiritualist type of a person?
No. Well, I was raised in a very traditional Southern Baptist religion, as a matter of fact. But along the way, even about the time I was selected into the astronaut program, after I got my PhD, I started reading the work of J.B. Ryan and the work in parapsychology. And I realized that the experiments that they had been performing were valid, and it seemed that they were, then we in science were derelict in not trying to find an answer. Mm-hmm.
And what you were looking for answers, and so you are you saying that you did not find them in the traditional sense, in the path that people normally take to find answers?
Well, you can't explain these types of intuitive experiences, and I preferred the word intuitive to psychic. You can't explain them with normal classical Newtonian science. It turns out we have to go to quantum science,
mm-hmm.
and. For 80 years since the beginning of trying to understand quantum science, the dogma has been they don't really pertain to our scale size. It doesn't have much to do with us. It only has to do with subatomic particles. And that turns out not to be correct, that it has everything to do with us, and it's only in the recent years have we found the mechanisms to start to explain it. I'm getting an echo, I'm sorry. Is it okay to come through to you?
Well, you're sounding fine over here.
Okay, good. That's all we need.
Okay. Very good. All right. So you were in a search for answers, and you say that that your search – let me ask you, let's just try to get – I'm trying to get a timeline here. At what time in your life did you start, say, veering off the traditional path? I mean, was it in your youth, just as you entered a space program? Was it after that? I mean, what's the timeline here?
Well, as I started to go back and get additional education, dig deeper into science, and starting to look at the gap between science and religion. And I was very much in my religion, but starting to challenge some of the dogma. And I ran into some theological scholars that were asking questions too. But then it was when I really started getting interested in the so-called parapsychological phenomenon, and realizing that there were some very profound experiments being done that validated the existence of these type of events, and that in science we simply didn't have, within classical science, any sort of explanation. And that intrigued my interest and intrigued my curiosity.
Mm-hmm. And it intrigued your dog's curiosity.
Yes, I'm going to have to put them out, if you'll excuse me just a minute.
That's fine. All right, everybody, if you just tuned in, we are talking to Dr. Edgar Mitchell, who is now putting his dog into a space capsule type of apparatus, I'm sure.
Be right back.
Okay, no problem. All right, everybody, if you got a question for the doctor, go to the EdgeAM.com website as we wait for him to take care of the dog. I can understand perhaps he has a dog like the Edge, where we have trained our dog to seek out any paranormal type of activities that may be flying around. And it sounds like we're getting ready to come
back.
Okay,
well, set.
All righty. Hey, I understand. I have a dog myself. We call her Ripley after the woman in the movie Alien. So, you know.
Well, I have two of them here that are we're wanting to play and writing to play in my office here while I'm talking.
All right, I see. Okay, so we were talking about, I'm trying to get a timeline then, as to when you started to seek alternative information regarding what you want to view, as you view life,
Well, that was about in the early 60s, in the mid-60s. I was studying astronomy at Harvard and getting my PhD at MIT,
mm-hmm.
and starting to really look at cosmology, or what was our theories of how the universe originated, Big Bang or no Big Bang, all of it, and the work in space had not at that point started producing the magnificent work of the Hubble telescope that we have these days, which just adds fuel to the fire of the magnificence of this place that we inhabit. And the big picture helped us realize what really small potatoes we are in the larger scheme of things.
Mm-hmm.
And so it started with my interest in